Hello guys, so welcome to KO Tutorials. So here now I am coming up with one new tutorial on modeling a banana in Blender application. So now what we are going to do over here is let's get started. So very first of all, let's take a cube over here in Blender. Very first of all, let's go into this edit mode, press Ctrl R and let's just add a loop over here first. So we are going to add a loop at the center over here. Again press Ctrl R. Let's add a loop over here. After that, let's go into this, select the polygons and let's just extrude it up. So how we are going to extrude it is by pressing E also you can easily extrude it up. So slightly just extrude this up. So let's select this edges over here, or we can just go into the polygons and slightly rotate it. Press S slightly to scale it. So again we'll go into this, select this and again extrude it, slightly rotate it, again just push it up, slightly scale it, press E again, scale it, click OK. So once you're done, now again I'm going to use extrude, but before using extrude I'll again use S over here to scale that out, to scale that part out over here. And again I'll slightly extrude it up and I'll rotate it. So press Ctrl R, put a loop over here, press Ctrl R, put a loop over here, Ctrl R and put one loop over here. So after you are done with this, now I can again go over here, I can go into this edges, press Alt and select this edges, press S and you can easily scale it. So if you want to scale this edges, you can easily scale it, or you can slightly push it down. Again you can press Alt, you can slightly just push it down. After that I'll go over here, I'll use this edges over here and I can slightly push it in this way. So if you want to push this edges in this way, you can do that. So we can just select this polygons, slightly rotate it, slightly rotate it and push it up in this way. So once you're done, we can go into this modify over here and let's give subdivision surface. So you can just give subdivision surface over here. You can use again this edges over here and you can edit this. So subdivision surface will be beneficial to give some shapes over here. That's it. And now you have an option over here for smoothness. You can easily smooth it. You can easily do that. And even you can go into this, scale it. Much better. That's it. So I'll increase this and let's just apply it. So I can just go into this object mode and I can just slightly apply it. So definitely if you want to give more curve, you can just give more curve over here. So you can definitely reduce it. After that, now what I'll be doing over here is like, I'll go into this, into the texture pane. Let's go into the texture pane, and into the texture pane, let's set it as vertex pane. Into this vertex pane, let's go into color palette and let's add a color over here. And let's go on painting it. Let's just paint this color. So we can go into this paint and 30 vertex colors, and let's set it to dirt only, and strength 0.3 over here. After that, we can slightly add some greenish tone. If you want to add it, you can easily add it. Again, add one more color over here. Add some darker color. So we can add some darker. If you want, you can just reduce this over here. You can just check with the size over here. At the end, if you want to go with it, you can go with that. Not a problem. I can again go back to the object mode over here. And if I decide that I need to work on this shape, I can definitely go over here again. I can go into edit mode. I'll select the polygons and I'll slightly scale this. Much better. And you can slightly extrude it. And you can just increase this stuff back. So once you're done, you can just apply it, go into object mode, apply it. Again, let's go into the vertex pane over here, whatever stuff you're doing. Now, again, I'll go into this. To the vertex pane, so you can just add one more color. If you want to add some more darker color kind of stuff, you can slightly do that. That can be easily done over here in this way. All right. Now, after that, let's go into the option editor type. Let's give a shader editor. Into the shader editor, let's set it to object paint, shift A, and let's give an input over here as vertex color, and let's just connect this vertex color with the base color, and same you can connect it to the subsurface color. So you can easily just connect this stuff over here in this way. After that, you can go into this and you can just set it to cycle over here. For this, we'll be doing some settings over here. You can go over here, subsurface, you can increase it subsurface over here. You can increase it subsurface over here. You can keep the subsurface as 0.3 over here. Let's go down. Now we can go into the surface background and into the color. If you want, we can just go into the environment texture for HDRI, and let's call an HDRI over here. Let's call HDRI over here. All right, we keep this emission as black only, will not change right now. So we'll definitely go with some render settings afterwards. Over here into this specular, you can just reduce it specular over here. That's it. Let's go down. Alright, so guys, if any doubts, please write it in the comment section over here. So there are a few more things which I'll be showing you in the coming tutorial. So thanks for watching this tutorial.